In this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to create a realistic paper texture and how to add ink text on top of it. Hi guys, my name is Manuel. We create a nice and heavy handcrafted paper, and it's not just ink text, but any kind of content you can add with this setup. So let's get started. First of all, the paper texture. We create a comp for that and add a first solid. Name it background. Then use the effects and presets window to add a gradient ramp. We imagine the light to be at the top right corner. So let's set the start point there and change the color into almost white, like 250 RGB each. Then we set the endpoint at the opposite corner and use a light gray color, like RGB around 230 each. A very subtle gradient. We add another solid, name it large. To create the actual texture, we use turbulent noise. Fractal type, cloudy. Noise type, soft linear. We open transform, scale it way up to 1000. Complexity, 10. Then set the mode to overlay. This breaks up the clean linear gradient. We add another solid, name it medium. This time we change the size. 2500 by 2500 pixels. Why? You'll see in a moment. Again, we add turbulent noise. Fractal type, threads. Noise type, spline. Contrast around 230. Brightness, minus 57. In transform, we deselect uniform scaling, set scale width to 30, scale height to 400. We want the lines to run in a diagonal direction, in a 90 degree angle to our light direction. Roughly. So we rotate the layer minus 45 degrees. That's why we need the solid to be bigger. Then we set the mode of the solid to screen. The texture is very subtle, but that's exactly what we want. We duplicate the layer, set the mode to overlay, and adjust the turbulent noise settings. Basic, soft linear, contrast 320, brightness minus 40, scale width 20, scale height 200. The turbulent noise effects create uniform and repetitive patterns. To make it look as natural and organic as possible, we need to add a few layers on top of each other with different settings. So we duplicate the top layer, set the mode to screen this time. Change the scale to 10 and 50. And change the evolution to around 300. This is how it looks like. And one more time, scale 10 and 400. And we change the evolution again, 110 maybe. So we have a lot of large and medium sized elements. Let's add some small ones. We add a new solid, name it small. Add turbulent noise again, smeary, soft linear, contrast 250, brightness minus 20, scale 30, complexity 20. And we change the mode again to screen. We duplicate it. Fractal type, basic, scale, 5. Let's have a quick look. And this time we set the opacity of the layer to 50%. We duplicate it one last time, change the contrast to 420, the brightness to minus 40. Let's check it out. And finally, we add an adjustment layer and add curves to slightly increase the contrast for the midtones. We want the texture to be very subtle. So be careful with that. Let's take a quick moment and check out an amazing in-depth animation course by Domestika. In this course, you'll learn how to create expressive typography in motion with After Effects. Design letter forms in Illustrator and animate them in After Effects. Start with research and references, color, then design a lettered phrase in Illustrator. Then in After Effects, animate it using kinetic typography. I've added the link to the course in the description. And even better, use the code MANUELDOESMOTION10 for an extra 10% off. Awesome! We created this beautiful handmade paper texture. Let's add some content. We create a new comp, same settings as your paper comp. Let's name it content. This will be the container for your content, whatever it is. I quickly add some text to show you how this works. Bunjazai. Regular. I hope I pronounced it somewhat right. The font is available on Adobe Font. We select the two comps and drag them on top of the comp icon down here. We want one new comp. Awesome. We duplicate the paper comp, move it up, and set the content track mat to Luma Matte. Then we add curves to the top paper comp. And basically increase the contrast until the texture shines through. And the curve depends on how covering you want your paint to be. Awesome! Then we add a displacement map to the content layer. And use the paper layer as displacement map layer. Effects and masks. And we set the displacement values to 5 each. This slightly roughens the edges of your content, influenced by the paper texture. The higher the values, the rougher the edges. We duplicate the content comp one more time, then go back into the paper comp and copy the medium layer. Paste it into our actual comp. And we use it as Luma Matte. Hide the solid, then use it as displacement map layer in the upper content composition. Let's set the mode of the solid to normal. And let's adjust some of the turbulent noise settings. A little less contrast, 175. And let's brighten it up, -5. Scale width and height, 100. And finally, we increase the displacement values in the displacement map. And we get these nice ink bleeds. All the effect values are my suggestions. I highly recommend playing around to come up with different textures and styles. I'll quickly animate a simple path to show you how it works. Here's a simple stroke. And let's have a look into the taper property. I've changed the values to slim the start and end. And I've set the line caps to round. Let's add trim paths and animate the endpoint with 2 keyframes. Alright, a very simple animation. We go back into our main comp, replace the 2 content comps, and you can see how the ink bleeds increase while the path is growing. Awesome! Check out the free project file with more animations. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like. Subscribe to my channel on the right side and hit the bell, because you don't want to miss my next video. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye, guys!